Hey there, how's it going? Tim Werner here. I wanted to take some time to explain to you the relationship between Azure subscriptions and Azure Active Directory. I find in working with students and in my consulting practice that this is often fuzzily understood at best. I want to start briefly with some definitions. A subscription in Azure is your pay-as-you-go or enterprise agreement or free trial, whatever level you're working with. It's your connection to Azure resources. And when you start a new Azure free account, you get your subscription attached to a single Azure Active Directory tenant. And in that Azure Active Directory instance or tenant, a tenant just refers to an instance of Azure AD, this is where you populate your users. And as it happens, there's a trust relationship between your Azure subscription and its associated Azure AD tenant. Resources trust accounts, as I learned when I originally became an Active Directory administrator in 2000. I need you to understand that each Azure subscription has a one-to-one trust relationship with an Azure AD tenant, and that's important to understand. I hope you see intuitively that it would be illogical for a single Azure subscription to be tied into more than one Azure AD identity store. But that having been said, your business may have multiple subscriptions in order to separate business units and payment methods and this sort of thing. Multiple subscriptions can in fact trust the same Azure Active Directory instance. So whereas each Azure subscription has a one-to-one relationship with an Azure AD tenant, you can in fact have multiple subscriptions all associated with that single identity store. That makes it more convenient to do administration. Another idea is your business may have more than one Azure Active Directory tenant. You may have completely separate environments for test, dev, QA, production, internal versus external, whatever the case may be. It's quite easy, although there's always some gotchas involved, to unplug an individual Azure subscription from one Azure AD tenant and plug it into another one. I'm going to show you all this in our demo. And the demo is going to consist of these parts. We're going to first make sure that we have appropriate Azure AD and subscription level permissions to do these actions. We'll then create a new Azure AD tenant in the Azure portal. We'll transplant an existing subscription to the new tenant, and then we'll review permissions and gotchas on the other side. Let's do this. Alrighty then, let's get this party started. Here we can see I'm in my Azure Active Directory tenant. You can see right on the overview page your current role, and I am a global administrator in this tenant. That's important because in order to do this kind of work with subscriptions and Azure AD tenants, you need to have top-level access. I also want you to see in the upper right, you see I have my login ID and also underneath a custom name that I've provided for this tenant. When you create your Azure free account, you're given an Azure AD instance that has the name Default Directory. If you go into the properties of your Azure Active Directory instance, this is where you can change the display name of the directory, and you'll also want to bind your custom DNS domain to Azure Active Directory so that you can create user IDs that replicate email accounts and just for better organizational purposes. As you probably know, you have the ability to switch directories by opening the user menu, and if this Tim at timw.info account has a login with multiple directories, we can absolutely do that. And we can also use the directory and subscription tool up here to switch the directory instantly, as well as to set favorites, default, etc. The other side of the equation here is the subscription. So let's navigate to the subscriptions blade, and we can see we're looking at three of my subscriptions. It's important that I have the owner role in order to transplant subscriptions. What we're going to do in this demo is take my VSEnt2150 subscription, and we're going to unplug it from timw.info and replug it into a brand new Azure Active Directory instance. Why would you do this? Remember that Azure AD is the identity store, so you may want to have that level of partitioning from the Azure AD tenant's perspective between business units, between customer and business, however you want to do it. Azure Active Directory is multi-tenant, remember, so we can have more than one instance. Let's go to Create a Resource, and in the Marketplace filter, we'll do Azure Active, and look not for B2C, but Azure Active Directory. Let's create a new tenant, and I'm going to call this for my organizational name, New Business Unit. Very inventive name, right? Now, the initial domain name's important because it can never be changed and it can never be deleted. It needs to be a globally unique name because it goes on Microsoft's onmicrosoft.com DNS domain. So I'm going to call this NBU for new business unit and maybe 704. I normally add a pseudo random number at the end to try to make it globally unique. Our country or region is US, and then it tells us that directory creation will take about 1 minute. Let's go ahead and create this, and I'll pause the video so you don't have to sit here waiting with me. I'm just sipping my espresso after all. And for convenience, the Azure portal gives us a click link to manage our new directory. I'm going to ignore that and show you how to get to our new directory by using the directory and subscription menu up here at top. So we'll come down under Switch Directory. I'll go to the All Directories view. I have a number of directories that I've created. We can see my new business unit right here. So let's select it to shift our perspective into that environment. Okay, so now we can see in the upper right that we're attached to the new business unit Azure Active Directory instance. Now, there's two things I want to point out here. This is a brand new empty directory. If we go to Azure Active Directory, we're going to see on the overview page, we're running not at the premium P2, which my TimW instance is, but at Azure AD Free. We can see that my role is still global administrator. You have to have that privilege in order to do this. And if we go to users, instead of having a big old list of users that I normally have with my TimW directory, here, let me collapse the text labels a bit. We can see there's only a single Azure Active Directory user. And notice that my source of authority is external Azure Active Directory. So Microsoft, or Azure, I should say, has federated me in because this ID, Tim at timw.info, is an Azure AD account that was created and sourced in timw.info. Now, we can definitely go ahead and create users and invite users in through B2B collaboration and do this, but at this point, we can't actually create anything because there's no subscription associated with this Azure AD tenant. If we click Add here for storage accounts to test, notice it tells us here we're signed into this directory that doesn't have any subscriptions. The subscription, I should have mentioned this earlier, reflects how you're paying for the Azure access. It's as simple as that. So I think you see the problem. We can stage the directory to our heart's content, but we're not going to deploy a single thing to it until we've added a subscription. So what I want to do now is switch back to timw.info. So let's do that from the directory dropdown. And then we'll navigate over to subscriptions, and I'm going to pick on my VS Ent2 150 subscription, of which I am the owner. We can check that really quickly by coming into the context of the subscription, going to Access Control IAM. On the Check Access page, I'm going to do a quick lookup on my ID. Once it's resolved, we'll click it, and we'll verify that we are in fact owner in this subscription, so I can move it with no problem. Let's come back to the overview page, and the secret here is to come over to Change Directory. What we're doing here is unplugging this subscription from my TimW directory, and we're going to plug it in, as you see with this 2 dropdown, into the new business unit directory, you see? It's as simple as that. However, I want you to pay attention to the warning text up above. This was the gotcha I told you about at the beginning of this lesson. When you redirect a subscription to a new directory, you're going to have to redo all your role-based access control. Hopefully that makes sense to you, because remember that all of your Azure resource stuff, your access control IAM stuff, is going to be tied into your tenant. So if we're going to a new tenant, hopefully it's just intuitively obvious that you know you'll have to redo your RBAC. Notice also that changing the directory does not change the billing ownership for the subscription. And what this means is that the Microsoft account that you used, or a colleague used, or whoever used to create the subscription is also the billing owner, and that particular identity will not change. And there's a Learn More link if you want to know more about that separation of duties between the subscription resource owner versus the billing owner. Oh, and one more thing. There's some other gotchas related to Key Vault and so forth. Just for completeness sake, I am a teacher after all. Let me show you an associated docs article you should check out to read more about the specific other gotchas, things that you might not have foreseen when you associate an Azure subscription to another tenant. This is a docs article called just that, Associate or Add an Azure Subscription to Your Azure Active Directory Tenant. Okay, so to complete this operation, let's click Change. and we'll wait for this to complete. Let's open up the notification bell, and it says here that the VSN2 subscription was moved to the new business unit directory. To view this subscription, switch to the new directory. Okay, cool. Well, let's again use the directory switch tool. Go back to all directories, and if we're going to be using this directory a lot, we might as well favorite. So notice that you can place a highlight in the little star icon, and then over on the favorites page, you can easily get to that other directory. So let's go back into the new business unit, and at this point, we should be able to create resources to our heart's content. Let's attempt to create a storage account. Click Add. There we go. Subscription VSEnt2150. We're off and running. So that concludes the demo. I hope that you're much clearer than you were about the relationship between an Azure subscription and Azure AD tenants. As far as takeaways are concerned, Microsoft published a really nice docs article on the subject of the relationship between subscriptions and tenants. The short URL I have for you is timw.info/sub1, S-U-B-1. If you want to reach out to me for any reason, my personal website is techtrainertim.com. My Twitter handle is, easily enough, TechTrainerTim, and you can check out my Pluralsight courses at timw.info/ps. Thanks very much for joining me here. I hope you got a lot out of this video. Take good care.